Je donne maintenant la parole à la représentante du Liban. Madame, vous avez la parole.
Thank you, Madame President. I would like to thank Belgium for convening this debate on a matter of paramount importance for all of us who hold dear the fundamental values of truth, justice, peace, and the rule of law. We see it as an essential discussion and a logical follow-up to the debate held last November on the role of reconciliation in maintaining international peace and security. Today's discussion is taking place at a particular time for my country, as tomorrow will mark the 15th anniversary of the assassination of Prime Minister Rafiq Hariri. It led to the adoption in 2007 of Security Council Resolution 1757, establishing the Special Tribunal for Lebanon, a hybrid tribunal created to find the truth and bring to justice the perpetrators of the heinous attack and to end impunity. In this regard, let me refer here to the ministerial declaration adopted by our newly formed government a few days ago, where the Council of Ministers reaffirmed its commitment to the work of the Special Tribunal for Lebanon to ensure that law and justice prevail, far from any politicization and any spirit of revenge, so that it does not have a negative impact on the stability of Lebanon, its unity, and its civil peace. Unity and civil peace are not mere words in my country, which was torn apart by a 15-year-long civil war and where thousands of people were killed or went missing. A Red Cross study concluded that 75% of Lebanese citizens had personal experience of armed conflict. A positive step towards restoring truth was taken in November 2018 when the Lebanese parliament adopted Law 105 on missing and forcibly disappeared persons. This legislation recognizes the right of families to know the fate of missing loved ones, and to this end seeks to establish an independent national commission. Let me add that the adoption of this significant law was made possible thanks to the key role of partners such as the ICRC, NGOs, the International Center for Transitional Justice, to name a few, and civil society. This type of collaborative partnership remains essential towards our road to sustaining peace. Such partnership evidences the necessity of implementing a comprehensive approach to transitional justice, premised upon the inclusion of all relevant stakeholders. Here, youth should be given the important role that they deserve to have in transitional justice as agents of change, to quote the ICTJ. Their participation in transitional justice and reconciliation should be central and not symbolic. Resolution 2250 on youth, peace, and security recognizes this role. In the same vein, we continue to believe that women's participation should be central also. Actually, here I would like to mention that Tunisia, the Tunisian Commission for Dignity and Truth, was headed by a woman. Furthermore, as conflicts and grievances take on varied forms, there is a need for context-sensitive local transitional justice cognizant of national and cultural sensitivities. Madam President, throughout the world and across history, human rights abuses, humanitarian law violations, conflicts and cycles of violence have ravaged countries. Such proliferation of suffering tears apart communities and has the potential to entrench instability, which threatens the prospects of peace. Transitional justice is essential to move forward, but you need to transition first out of the conflict situation to start the process of healing. In our region, continuous and perpetual conflicts are the major obstacle to transitional justice, and time is of essence to transition from conflict to justice in a reasonable time frame. Justice delayed is justice denied. Here, let us recall that this august body has a great responsibility in ending conflicts so that peace can take hold and transition starts. Instead of burying grievances and remaining enslaved to the chains of the past, transitional justice provides a range of mechanisms allowing first the citizen and then the country to achieve sustainable and meaningful peace. I thank you.
Je remercie la représentante du Liban et je donne maintenant